Okay, here we go again. So this is for my baby sister. I promised her that every time I use my Instant Pot, I'm gonna be making a video just so that I can show her how to use it. So I'm gonna be making some beans. These are red beans, Central American red beans, frijoles rojo. So this is a whole bag, as you can see, dry. All I'm gonna do is open it, I'm gonna clean it up, I'm gonna rinse it, and then I'm gonna put it in my Instant Pot, and I'll bring you back in a minute. Okay guys, so I'm back. I rinse and clean my beans. I don't know if you can see really closely, but I'm gonna try and bring you up. You see that it has, right here, you have cups and whatnot. So I added roughly minus that 5.5 cups of water is what I'm using for my beans. Normally, it's advised, obviously, for you to let your beans hydrate. And if you can leave them at least 45 minutes in water to an hour or maybe overnight. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. And today, I'm not going to. I am going to go ahead and place my, I myself like to use the manual setting. I don't really use the pre-programmed setting that's on the Instant Pot, and I'll show you what I mean, because I pretty much have an idea how much time it's gonna take. So there goes my Instant Pot. And like I said, it's about 5.5 cups of water is what I put in here. And now I'm just gonna place it. This part goes to my left. I already turned it on, and then turn it to your right. Okay guys, so I turned it around so you can see what I'm looking at. But you see here, it says beans and chili. I rather do it manual. So what I do is I go to manual here. I'm gonna do 25 minutes and see where I'm at, and that's all that you do, and you leave it alone. But if you wanted to use this setting, then all you do is hit this and forget and walk away, and you're fine. As long as you have, you see how it beeps, meaning that it's on, and it's gonna start doing its thing. And my gauge here, my temperature pressure gauge is to the back, and you can see this is down, and I'll bring you back whenever it's done so I can show you what it looks like. Hey Mana, baby sister, just to let you know, previous to this, it beeped, it went beep, 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 and then it's on low and it's gonna start counting again. And that is what's, at that point, it's gonna start bringing down the pressure. And let's see, and it's gonna keep it warm once the pressure is down that you're able to open it. But you see here what I mean? You see where this is at? There's no way you can open this, okay? Just keep that in mind. We still have a little bit. We gotta wait for the pressure now to go down before we can open the pot and see what the beans look. Okay, Mana, so you see it is done. Check it out. You see how it went down? This is the time in which you open it. See that? Whoops. And you just, you know. And they, oh my goodness, they're done, all right. I can tell they're done. Hold on, let me get a, I'm sorry. Okay, let's see what these look like. See, look at that. Now these particular beans don't render a lot of cream or whatever. I don't know what you want to call it. They don't, but I just want to see if they're, oh yeah. So what I do from this point on, either I'll leave it here and just use my saute button and it'll just keep cooking. You don't have to put the lid on. I'll do that and add all of my seasonings that I want, or I'll transfer it to a pot and do it up on the, finish it on the stove so it could, because I don't like it to be runny like this, see? I like it to be a nice, thicker consistency of the drippings here. See, that's too loose for me, but I am gonna put it on saute because I'm gonna add a little bit more water. Actually, you gotta turn it off first, right here, cancel. Now saute, and it'll do for 30 minutes. And I'll add a little bit of water and let it just continue to simmer there. But there you have it, Mana. You see, Mana, on the saute. And if for some reason you're not satisfied and you want it a little bit more well done, you can just, because it only does saute for 30 minutes and then it goes into keep warm. You can always do another 30 minutes, but remember, you got to turn it off, cancel it, and then turn the saute, okay? Okay, Mana, so at this point, it is all done. But you see how creamy it is versus what it was earlier? It's very creamy. What I like to do at this point, because I'm not going to cook this today, I only did this video for the purpose of showing you how to do it. I like to take some plastic containers, I put them in these, I let it cool completely, and I don't fill it all the way to the top because I'm going to put these in the freezer. And when you put them in the freezer, if you fill them too high, the lid, as it freezes and it gets solid, the lid will pop off because the solid, you know, it'll create ice, as you well know. And then, so you got to give it a little bit of room to allow it, that way it's in the freezer, it rises a little bit. And then you can, you know. Anyway, just wanted to show you. It says off. I'm going to just unplug it here. But basically, you get the idea. Let me get my thing so I can show you. So now all I'm going to do is actually, oh my gosh, Cecilia, the things you do for love. Anyway, so all I'm going to do is take this like so. Oh God, I'm going to make a mess. I know it. And like that. See that? And like this. I'm going to have to clean this stuff. And it's probably, I'm going to have probably enough for two, but not more than two. And you see, there's not a lot of, it doesn't render a lot of juice, these beans. But you can certainly add more water to it and make it thicker, etc. So, I'm going to let this get cool, completely cool, before it goes in the freezer. I'll bring you back in a minute to show you. Okay, so here you have it. You see? All I'm going to do is leave it on the countertop. And when it's completely cool, I'll cover it, put a date on it, and then I'll put it in the freezer to use at a later day. At which time, I can either make habichuelas guisada, which is, you know, you make them with sauce and whatnot, or I can make rice and beans with it together because they are just at the right peak for that. So, or you can take them both and make, use it to make sancocho de habichuela, which is a bean stew that we make back home. And you add plátanos, you add meat, you add yuca, etc. So anyway, there you have it, Mana. Love you. I hope you give this a try. And don't be afraid. Once you get the hang of your Instant Pot, you'll be a pro. You won't even think about it twice, girl. And you'll be making this and much more. Love you.